Thank you and greetings, AX3 crew. This is Axiom Space Chief Scientist Dr. Lucie Low. I am so excited to talk to you today about the science experiments and technology demonstrations occurring on the ISS as part of AX3. Now, MLA, it has been a pleasure working with this team as we continue to expand this global community of international scientists that can work and conduct research on this really unique orbiting lab. So with that, I'd love to ask the team some questions about what you and the crew have been doing. So I'm going to start with you, if that's all right, Commander LA. So I bet it's great to be back in space and performing research that could benefit humans and commercial industry back here on Earth. Now, this is a mostly government-sponsored research mission, although there are some research projects that are partnership between commercial and academic partners. Can you tell us a bit about the work the team has been doing on the ISS?
Of course, you hit the nail on the head, Dr. Low. We are doing a whole range of experiments, both scientific and also technology demonstrations, as well as a lot of outreach events. I would say I'll let the guys talk about their specific portfolios, but the majority of the science is in human health, specifically biology, also material science, robotics, and artificial intelligence. So it spans pretty much the gamut of what laboratories on Earth are doing. And of course, the individual agencies have sponsored this research by going through two researchers throughout their native countries and finding interesting things that they're trying to identify the uses of exploiting the microgravity environment to compare with what they could do on Earth. So this is an exciting time, which is really continuing the legacy of what ISS has been doing for over two decades now.
Thank you, LA. That's a fantastic overview of the portfolios. So one question for you. So when you go back to space, is it doing the research when the equipment starts floating away? Is it a bit like riding a bike in that it all comes back to you because you've been up there a few times now and you know exactly what you're doing?
You know, a little bit. I would say that it takes a little longer to learn how to ride the bike again than just hopping right on. As you know, microgravity is a very unique environment and humans are not used to that. So when we get on board, it's like we don't know how to walk. We don't know how to do the simplest things. And you have to relearn that. We have a phrase which is slow is smooth and smooth is fast. So if you really want to be careful and slow, that's basically the best way to get from one place to another. But things do start to learn. And I think we're all learning quite a bit. I feel like we're a lot better than we were a week ago, but we're still not quite as good as the expedition crew who's been on board for 4 or 5 months.
I'll bet. Well, it sounds like you guys are doing a great job up there, and it sounds like excellent advice for those of us in labs down here on Earth as well. So with that, I'd love to ask some questions from the other members of the AX3 crew. So I'm going to start with pilot Colonel Walter Villaday, if that's okay. So Walter, the Italian mission is a whole of country endeavor and consists of experiments from the Italian Air Force, Italian Space Agency, and many commercial Italian companies that want to leverage microgravity for product development and testing, and also to investigate the physiological effects of spaceflight on humans, for example. Can you tell me about some of the research you've been doing on this mission and why it's important to Italy?
Yeah, sure. I would start saying why it's important for Italy. I'm very proud of this mission because we were able to get together different entities, starting from the MOD and the Air Force, but even bringing together the academic scientific community and the industries. So just to mention some of the experiments in our portfolio, I've been working in a couple of experiments, amyloid and the Prometeo 2, and they are intended to study the processes of the aggregation of some proteins that are supposed to be the causes that can produce on the ground Parkinson's and Alzheimer's. So some of the diseases that are affecting our old people. So it's very important to study these processes. And one of the other two experiments is even producing some nanoparticles that might be a kind of a countermeasure for limiting or reducing these kind of diseases. And a couple of other experiments, we are dealing with technologies like fabrics, new fabrics capable to shield from the radiation. That is very much important if you want to keep expanding our exploration of the I mean, the space around the Earth, but even now thinking of farther. So we need to have some new fabrics, and I'm testing a new space flight suit just to have something to monitor the astronauts' conditions. And other experiments, like we are even studying the fertility of the female body, how some cells can be affected by the micrography. So it's a pretty rich and wide range of experiments up here, and I'm very glad to be able to contribute for these 14 days to push forward this frontier of the knowledge.
Don't forget about my favorite experiment, the pasta.
Oh yeah, that's been amazing. So I've been trying to cook differently pasta. So normally here pasta is supposed to be rehydrated. We just brought some packages of pasta, which might be just a simple warm it up, but nevertheless, it's still keep being quite al dente, as we used to say in Italy. And yesterday we had the pleasure to share this additional pasta with all the ISS crew members. So it's definitely, it's a good point, even, I mean, to expand the frontier of the space and expanding this community and to bring our culture in food and agriculture from Italy, but from many other countries, is definitely an enrichment of this endeavor.
Absolutely. Well, that is fantastic. And I'm sure everyone was very grateful to have some really delicious extra pasta meals while they're up there to keep you all busy and fueled while you're running around doing all this research. Next, I'd like to ask mission specialist Alper about his work in space. So, Alper, you've been helping Turkish researchers from across the nation test novel hardware that they've been developing for spaceflight. I know you've been looking at the effects of spaceflight on both plants and humans, and you've been taking part in lots of educational and outreach projects for school children across Turkey. Can you tell me anything else about the projects you've been undertaking for Turkey and why the whole of the nation is so excited about your mission?
Great to hear from you, Dr. Low. Thanks so much. You already summarized it pretty well. It's a pretty important mission for us, as it was decided on our centennial anniversary in a field like space where we have been away for so long. Even though we have been so far away from this field, especially for the manned space flight, we have been pretty motivated and determined to carry out and run as fast as possible in order to catch up with what we have lost so far. So up until now, we have already collected like 13 different fields of experiments from different fields of disciplines in science and research. Just to summarize a couple of them, as I said, even though we have never been into the manned space flight so far, we are still so determined to be able to contribute however we can. All the way from the beginning, we have already been implementing some studies in order to come up with the results of an alternative life support system for the future space flights in order to benefit from the functionality of the microalgae in order to scrap the carbon dioxide from the ambient ambient air over here in the ISS, scrap the carbon dioxide from it and come up with oxygen in a life support system, which is already being tested so far that we have set up at the very first stage. Secondly, we are trying to come up with natural ways of fighting with bacteria, potential bacteria, which might grow over here. So we are using quite a natural substance, which is the propolis, being used already on Earth for different occasions in order to fight with bacteria. So we have been collecting any potential samples here and trying to work on this propolis substance in order to see if it really reacts as it does on Earth. And lastly, I would like to just mention we're also working on the human anatomy related studies. And we have been collecting samples again in order to see the potential effects, negative and positive, of microgravity environments on the human body. So we're pretty determined in contributing several fields of space related research and also really motivational wise, our young generations are so excited. I have been trying to follow up with, keep up with the news coming from the country. I mean, the whole country, 5 million people were almost awake, trying to watch and follow the whole launch and the mission, as well as our experiments going on here. So there's a really big amount of population coming up and can't wait for the future space missions.
That's fantastic. Well, thank you for your inspiration with this mission, Alpa. And Marcus, I would love to ask you some questions. You've been very busy for ESA and the Swedish National Space Agency while in orbit. You've been doing experiments that are continued to build on ESA's mission to shape the development of European space capabilities and also bring value to the citizens of Europe and the world. So what kind of experiments have you been doing during your time on orbit?
Thank you very much. You summed up a little bit. It's a wide range of experiments, and it's within life science and tech demonstrations and material science, and also cognitive science and how we build and design our work environment. So a few examples is for instance, we're looking at bone mass loss and how that works and the process of that. During my mission, so we took samples before, we're doing it during, and we're looking at it after as well, and to see how that process works and learn more about it. And we're also looking at the effect of microgravity on stem cells. So we brought stem cells up here, both that have not been exposed to microgravity before, but also that's been on sounding rockets and exposed to microgravity for a short time, where we have seen that the proliferation and the differentiation between the cells is affected in a positive way. There's a lot of challenges for cells in microgravity, but there also seems to be positives. And for these neural stem cells, we're looking at the effect of longer time of microgravity now. And also tech demonstrations, for instance, controlling robots on Earth from space. So we've done that from here now, and which is on Earth in a simulated Moon or Mars environment to control either one robot or several robots at the same time and have collaboration between them for remote operations in the future. We've also been looking at the utilization of artificial intelligence for task assistance and for different interactions on the space station as well. And with some of the medical things we're looking at also is effects on the brain before and after and due to the microgravity and also mostly the spatial orientation. So on a brain level, we're looking at the changes due to this high stress exposure and difference in orientation. And by doing that, we can learn about vertigo and other things that we want to work with on ground. So that's science that really goes back to and benefits Earth, medical science on Earth. So it's a lot of fun, a lot of different science up here.
So we have just 2 minutes left, and I have a very rapid fire question for the first time flyers. So if you can all just tell me very quickly, what has been the most surprising thing to you guys about doing the research in space?
Well, I will start. I mean, the most surprising part of being here and doing science, it's first of all, looking at the space station as a complex system is amazing. So you can be, I mean, we've been studying the ISS, but working daily over here, it's amazing. And then, of course, it's not strictly related with scientific matter, but when you can go to the cupola and look up down and see the Earth, it's amazing. It's really something that can... you can explain until the moment you really see with your eyes.
Yeah, the diversity, I would say, even though I knew the diversity, but when you actually execute it and you think about what you've been doing during the day and realize how many different science topics you've been touching and how big groups of people that you've been interacting with directly or indirectly on ground during the science is striking. And it's a lot of things to learn here.
And any possible opportunity of
that Thank you, Alper. Thank you, everyone. So this is fantastic to hear about the research you've been doing, and thank you for connecting with me today. So I want to thank you all from us on here on the ground that your work is really opening the door for more scientists and researchers from around the world to continue to and advance groundbreaking research in microgravity. So have fun, guys, and we'll see you back in Houston.
Thanks, Lucie.
Thank you.
All the best, everybody.